Okay. So far we have we have covered out of this design objectives ng control systems which we have enumerated at the start of this at the start of this course. We have so far covered one, okay, which is to produce the desired transient response. Okay. Now, in the next in the next two topics, okay, in the next two sections, okay. We will cover now yung stability at saka yung steady state error. Okay, so in this case, we will first cover yung stability. Okay? And then on the next section, we will cover steady state error. Okay. So stability is the most important specification. Okay? So we should remember that without stability, okay, or without ensuring first that your system is stable. Your system design is basically moot and academic. Ibig sabihin, walang silbi yung efforts natin to design the transient response and the steady state error kung unstable naman yung system ninyo. Okay? So before a control systems engineer analyzes a system for transient response and steady state error, he or she should be first concerned about the stability of the system. Okay, so basically, ang proseso talaga bago tayo dapat makapag-analyze is we first ensure na stable yung system natin. Okay, so far dun sa ating transient response or yung nung kinover natin yung transient response, we are assuming that your system is stable. Okay, and in fact, kapag naman tinest nyo lahat yung systems natin before, okay, we are assured na stable naman talaga siya. Okay, pero ang totoong proseso talaga niyan is dapat we have to ensure first that your system is stable before you actually proceed analyzing the transient response and steady state error. Okay. Then as engineer moves to design the system for desired transient response and or steady state error, okay, he or she should have an idea of the extent of the changes on system parameters he or she can make to keep the system stability. So habang dinedesign nyo naman, okay, so dun sa analysis part, kailangan tingnan nyo muna kung stable yung system bago nyo siya i-analyze for steady state response and for transient response and steady state error. Sa design part, habang nagde-design kayo, kailangan ini-ensure nyo na yung changes dun sa yung gagawin yung mga changes dun sa system parameters would keep the system in its stable state. Okay, otherwise, kapag ka nakuha nyo nga yung transient response na gusto nyo, pero nung pinalitan nyo naman yung system parameters nyo, bigla siya naging unstable, then wala rin silbi yung dinesign ninyo. Okay. Now, in this section, we will define stability. Okay. Study a tool to analyze the stability of systems and design system parameters and transfer functions that will keep the system within its stable condition. Okay. Now, at the end of this lesson, you should be able to, one, define stability and explain the necessary conditions that makes a system stable, marginally stable, and unstable. Two, make and interpret a Routh table. Okay, the basic one, the first row element is zero, or the entire row is zero to determine the stability of a system. And determine the range of values allowed for a system parameter to keep the system within a stable region of its operation. So, ito yung ating lesson outcomes. Okay. In the discussion of time response in the previous lesson, we have stated that the time response of a system has two components. Okay. So, we have the natural response and the forced response. Okay. So that we say that the total response is the forced response plus the natural response. Okay. So we also have emphasized in the previous discussion that full control. Ibig sabihin, kapag yung system ninyo is under a state na nakokontrol talaga natin siya. Okay. Is achieved if the steady state response of the system has the same form of the output. Meaning, kung ang ating input ay step, dapat ang ating output should be kung ang input natin ay step, dapat ang output natin should be a constant or has a constant steady state response. Okay, and so on, okay? Pero possibly of different magnitude. Okay, so pwedeng iba yung level niya. Okay? Thus, for a full control, okay, the natural response should decay to zero. Okay, so kailangan itong ating ano, itong ating natural response na to, okay? Itong ating natural response na to should decay to zero. Kapag ka nagaan tayo, nagkakaroon tayo ng, or kapag ang system natin is under control. Okay? Now, from there, doon natin malalaman or doon natin madederive yung ano, yung definitions ng stability, ng instability, and marginal stability. So, bali, in terms ng stability, meron tayong tatlong states. Okay? Whether your system is unstable, okay, or yung state of instability, okay, meron tayong system na stable, okay, at meron tayong system na marginally stable o yung system natin na nasa state ng marginal stability. Okay? So, an LTI system is stable. Okay? An LTI system is stable if the natural response approaches zero. Okay? As time approaches infinity. So, alam na natin yan. Dapat mag-approach ng zero yung natural response natin. As time approaches infinity, para masabi natin na yung system natin ay stable. Now, if otherwise, if the natural response grows without bound, okay, as time approaches infinity, then you can say that your system is unstable. Okay? And then, finally, an LTI system that is marginally stable, okay, pag sinabi nyo ang system ninyo ay marginally stable, if the natural response neither decays nor grows, but remains constant, okay, or oscillates as time approaches infinity. Kung ang ano ninyo, kung ang natural response ninyo mag-oscillate after some time. Okay? At nananatili, at yung oscillation naman niya has a constant amplitude. Okay? O kaya kung hindi man siya nag-oscillate, eh magme-maintain siya ng isang constant value. Okay? Then your system is said to be marginally stable. Yung natural response lang pinag-uusapan natin, ha. Okay? So ayun, yun yung tatlong definition ng ano, ng stability. But this is based on the behavior of your natural response, which madalas hindi natin talaga to ma-derive with ano, with direct measurements. Okay? Kasi ang ma-measure lang talaga natin is total response. Okay? So we would not be able to measure this directly. Okay? Hindi natin siya ma-measure directly kasi natural response yung pinag-uusapan. O natural response yung ginagamit as a basis of definition of stability. Okay. A better way, a more practical way to actually measure yung stability ng system niyo is actually to look for the total response. Okay, kasi pag nag-measure tayo ng response, mas ano, mas nakikita natin, okay, or mas na ma-measure natin directly yung total response ng system niyo. Okay. Now, obviously, kung titingnan natin yung total response, tapos alam nyo na yung input nyo is bounded. When you say an input is bounded, it means na yung value nung input ninyo has a certain finite value. Okay? So, hindi man siya magstay dun sa finite value na yun. At least, hindi siya, ano, hindi siya lumalagpas dun sa finite value na yun. So you say that your input is bounded. Example ng mga bounded input is ano, yung delta t. Okay? Example natin is yung delta t. Okay? Example din natin is yung step function. Okay? Example na din natin step function. Okay? And then example din natin is yung sinusoidal function. Okay? Yan. Yan yung mga example natin ng ano, ng mga bounded input. Yung ramp, okay, yung ramp function natin at saka yung parabolic function natin. Okay? Yan. Yung ramp function natin which is at t, u of t. These two are unbounded inputs or unbounded signals. Kasi yan ay tumataas as your t approaches infinity. Okay. So itong tatlo, itong delta t, itong u of t, at saka itong sinusoidal natin, these are bounded inputs or bounded signals. Okay? So ngayon, kapag yan ang in-input ninyo, okay, if you have an input of delta t, u of t, or sine u of t, okay, and your total response, okay, and the total response does not approach infinity as time approaches infinity, ibig sabihin hindi umakyat sa isang unbounded value yung total response nyo. Okay. Then, we can say that the natural response is not approaching infinity and thus the system is stable. So, obviously, kapag ang bounded, pag ang input nyo ay bounded, you are expecting na dapat ang output nyo is also bounded. Okay. Para masabi nyo na yung system ninyo ay stable. Okay. Otherwise, kung ang input nyo ay unbounded, okay, obviously, yung total response nyo should also become unbounded. Okay. Kaya lang, in that case, hindi natin masasabi ngayon kung nag-decay ba sa zero yung natural response ninyo. So, therefore, wala tayong conclusions dito. Okay. Basta sigurado tayo, kung bounded yung input, dapat bounded din yung output. Yun yung sinasabi natin. Okay. Pero kung unbounded yung input, hindi natin masasabi ngayon kung stable. Hindi natin masasabi ngayon kagad outright kung stable yung system nyo o hindi. Okay. So, from this, okay, from this, ano, we can define now stability based naman sa relationship ng input at saka ng output ninyo. Okay. So, a system is stable if every bounded input yields a bounded output. Okay. We call this the BIBO. Bounded input, bounded output stability requirement. Okay. So, kapag bounded ang input, dapat bounded ang output. Your system is stable then. Okay. Now, a system is stable, is unstable. Okay. If any bounded input, okay, yung input nyo is bounded. Okay. Pero, it yielded an unbounded output. So, yung output ninyo ay tumaas without limit. Okay. So therefore, in that case, you can say that your system is unstable. Okay? Now, a system is marginally stable if it is stable for some inputs and unstable for others. Okay? So actually, ang medyo mahirap i-interpret yung marginal stability kapag ka output yung tinitingnan. So we will have some alternative definitions. Kaya kapag ka talaga nagde-define tayo o nag-aantay ng stability ng system natin, we actually look at the signals, okay? We actually look at the input and output signals. And then we actually inspect yung natural response kung kaya natin siyang i-isolate para malaman natin kung siya talaga ay stable o hindi. Okay? Pero again, ang pinakamagandang sign na ang system niyo ay stable is if it follows the input. Kung sinusundan ng output, okay, kung sinusundan ng output ng system niyo yung input, okay, and then you were able to achieve a full control, then you can say that your system is stable. Okay? So, kung halimbawa ang system niyo ay ang input ninyo ay sinusoidal at ang output ninyo naging sinusoidal din, then it more or less stable yung system ninyo. Yun nga lang, di natin masabi kung siya ay stable or marginally stable. So, dun lang medyo magkakaroon ng konting confusion or ambiguity. Okay. So, yeah. Now, how can a system be concluded as stable? So, paano ba natin nakoconclude as stable yung system natin? Okay. Looking into the natural response, which is required to approach zero as time approaches infinity, it can be seen that the system poles that yield the natural response should be negative. Okay, if they are real or have negative real parts if they are complex. Okay, obviously, yung system poles ninyo that yield the natural response, dapat magde-decay siya sa zero. So therefore, kung real pole man siya, dapat negative siya. Dahil magkakaroon kayo ng yung pole na 'yon, would actually generate an exponential that has a negative exponent. For example, kung meron kayong expression or meron kayong kung isa sa mga partial fraction decomposition ng system ninyo or ng response ninyo would be a over s plus sabi natin 4. Okay? Pag ito in-inverse ninyo, magiging a e raised to negative 40 yan. Okay? So kapag ito kasama ngayon to sa natural response ninyo, obviously itong e raised to negative 40 would decay to 0. Okay? Otherwise, kung ang nakalagay sa partial fraction decomposition ninyo is a over s minus 4. Okay? Mag-ano to ng inverse inverse Laplace transform na a over ng a e raised to 40. At yung a e raised to 40 na yan. Okay, sorry. Hindi niyo pala nakikita. Ayan. So, halimbawa kung meron siyang partial fraction decomposition na a over s minus 4. Pag in-inverse niyan, magiging a e raised to 40 yan. Okay. And obviously, itong a e raised to 40, alam natin na ito, magkano yan. Hindi yan magde-decay. But rather, mag-i-increase yan to infinity. Okay. So, therefore, that would render your system to be unstable. Okay. Ganun din kapag ka, meron kayong complex exponential, complex poles. Okay. So, halimbawa, meron kayong a s plus b over s plus, sabi natin 2, square plus 4. Okay. So, kapag in-inverse nyo yan, it would have something like, e raised to negative 2t times cosine 2t plus a cosine 2t plus b sine 2t. Okay? So, alam natin na since ito ay negative, kahit na meron kayong sinusoidal dito, magdidecay yung dalawang sinusoids na yan. Because you are multiplying it with a negative exponential. Okay? Whereas, kung magiging positive siya, okay, kung magiging positive ito, then we can say na hindi ito magdidecay to zero, but rather mag-i-increase yan to infinity as your time approaches infinity. Okay? So yun yung requirement do sa mga poles natin in terms ng positioning ng poles sa S-plane o sa complex S-plane. We need these poles to be in the negative side. Okay? So yung sinasabi nga natin before na dapat nasa left half plane siya. Or dapat lahat ng system poles niyo nasa left half plane. Okay? So, stable systems have closed loop transfer functions with poles only in the left half plane of the complex S-plane. Okay? So, dapat yung closed loop poles niyo, okay, are in the left half plane of the complex S-plane para siya maging stable. Okay? Those systems with at least one closed loop pole that is on the right half plane, at least, kahit isa lang. Okay? At least one. Okay? They are deemed to be unstable. Kahit isa lang. At kahit konting-konti lang yung pagka-positive niya. Ibig sabihin, kahit 0.1 lang yan. Yung pole mo is at 0.1. Basta positive. Your system is rendered unstable. Now, systems whose closed loop poles, okay, that are on the J omega axis, meaning ando siya mismo sa boundary ng left half plane at right half plane, and multiplicity of 1 are marginally stable systems. Okay? So kung meron kayong system na halimbawa ito yung S-plane natin. Tapos meron kayong pole dito sa ating J omega axis. This is your J omega axis. Okay. Kung meron kayong pole dyan, tapos ang multiplicity nila 1, okay, you can say that your system is marginally stable. Okay. Pero kung nag-double pole siya at the same position, hindi na stable yan. Okay, so this renders your system to be unstable already. Pagka nag-double pole siya dun sa same position sa J omega axis. Okay, kasi yung mga ganyan, yung mga ganyan ano, mag-ano yan, mag-yield yan ng inverse na T sine o kaya cosine omega T. Okay, and may T na to, this T increases as your time increases. Okay, so therefore, this is a very this is an increasing function. Okay? So yung system na halimbawa, meron kang pole dito, tapos meron kang pole sa left half plane. Okay, this is considered to be marginally stable. Okay? So as long as meron kang ano, meron kang pole dun sa ating meron kang pole dun sa ating J omega axis. Okay? This is considered to be marginally stable. Basta wag lang sila mag-double pole. Kahit marami sila diyan, halimbawa meron pang isa dito. Okay. Meron pang dalawa diyan. Okay. Marginally stable pa rin 'yan. Basta wag lang sila magda-double pole doon sa isang ano, sa isang location. Okay. So, ayan. So we have here an example of ano or example of systems na ano na we have here an example of systems na ano na stable tsaka unstable. Okay. So yung system ninyo na stable pag ito pag nilagay niyo sa ano sa closed loop transfer function. Okay. Remember dapat ito gawin natin tong closed loop transfer function. Okay. So magiging ano to? 3 all over s times s plus 1 times s plus 2 plus 3. Kailangan maging closed loop 'yan. Tapos kukunin natin yung poles niyan in which that would give us this one. Okay. So makikita natin yung tatlong poles natin, ito, ito, tsaka ito. These are on the left half plane. So we are ensured na yung system ninyo ay stable. So magre-return niya ng system na underdamped and at the same time, alam natin may full control. O meron tayong full control dun sa ating system. Okay? Kasi susundan niyo yung input ninyo na step input. Okay, so this system is stable. Otherwise, ito, okay. Again, i-reduce natin ito sa ano? I-reduce natin ito sa kanyang closed loop form. So this becomes 7 all over s times s plus 2, sorry, s plus 1 times s plus 2 plus 7. Okay, tapos pag kinuha natin yung poles niyan, okay, we will have the following. We will have the poles here, here, tapos ito. Okay, meron kayong dalawang poles dun sa right half plane. Okay, meron kayong poles dun sa right half plane. So therefore, the system is unstable. So, may verify nyo yung pag-renap nyo, makikita nyo na yung signal niyo lumalaki as your time progresses. So, we will say that this system now is unstable. Okay? So, ayan. Now, determining the stability of feedback control systems is not as simple as that, however. Some systems will have higher ordered faults when reduced to an equivalent closed-loop transfer function, which requires factoring and solving for the roots of the denominator of the transfer function. Pero sa atin, sa in the presence of ano, in the presence of computing tools such as MATLAB and Octave. Actually, hindi na masyado mahirap para sa atin 'to. Okay, kahit na ang kahit na meron kayong ano, 10 poles. Okay. Kayang hanapin niya ng MATLAB tsaka ng ano ng Octave. Okay, masasolve ng MATLAB yung 10 poles na yan kapag meron kayong gamit na MATLAB tsaka Octave. Okay. Kaya lang still kapag ka nagde-design tayo, hindi natin magagamit yung MATLAB tsaka Octave kasi there is this system parameter na kailangan nating palitan ng value in which hindi siya directly may evaluate ng MATLAB at saka ng Octave unless i-program natin siya to do just that. Okay. So, this motivation of us na kahit na meron tayong tool to compute for this root, this poles, okay, kailangan pa rin nating aralin yung tinatawag nating tool. Okay, we will study in the next lesson yung tinatawag nating route Hurwitz criterion in which that tool enables us to determine yung state of stability ng system natin, okay, without actually computing for the location of the poles ng ating system. Okay. Now again, ang motivation natin to study that tool is not hinge on the fact na gusto talaga nating malaman yung stability ng system natin, but rather on the design side. Okay. Well, we can use that to determine yung range of values for our system parameters so that we will maintain yung stability ng system natin at malalaman natin kung kailan siya magiging unstable. Okay. So,